So let's start with the session. Good evening, everyone. On the behalf of Team Dentist Channel Online, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you on today's webinar on the topic Botulinum Toxin in Facial Aesthetic Medicine by Dr. Kanika Wadhwa. So before starting with the session, I have a few housekeeping notes to make. If you have joined us from our live session, you can put your doubts in your question and answer box, and each and every question will be taken up at the end of the session. If you have joined us from Facebook and YouTube Live, you can ask us questions by commenting, and we'll be taking up your questions at the end of the session. So without further ado, I would like to introduce our today's speaker to everyone. Just a second. I'm really sorry. Okay. Dr. Kanika has completed her post-graduation diploma and fellowship in aesthetic medicine from Germany, and currently she's practicing in Gurugram, Haryana since more than 10 years by the name of Global Health Xpertz. She has started charitable organization by the name of NAMASVI, a ray of hope on the name of her daughter's names, Namya and Tejasvi, for helping underprivileged people medically. She has been awarded Women's Excellence Award of Best Dentist and Cosmetologist by Lifestyle Magazine. Over to you, ma'am.
Very good evening. And thank you so much, Aditi, for providing me this platform. And it is a wonderful platform which you provide to speakers to share their knowledge, their insights on topics, and to keep all the doctors updated on all the topics related to dentistry and also aesthetic medicine. I am very, very fortunate to be associated with this Dentist Online, and I rely on this site very often. Whenever I have any doubts or anything, I always go back to, because the best part is that the sessions are streamed on Facebook, on YouTube. So you can, even if you miss at that time, you can get back to the sessions later on and can keep yourself updated. So it is a win.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for being so kind. The stage is all yours now.
Thank you so much. So today we'll be discussing about botulinum toxin. It is a magical toxin which is used in facial aesthetic medicine, and it is used widely. We'll discuss about it all step by step. So before I start with it, I would like to discuss little about facial aesthetics. This is a very, very talked and very fond, people are very fond of facial aesthetics these days, because it is all about rolling back years for somebody, for getting back your youthful face, and it is basically anti-aging treatments. So in that, role of Botox cannot be overlooked, because it is the most widely and most safely used toxin, which is not only used in aesthetics, but also now these days it is used for therapeutic uses like migraine and all. So we'll be discussing it all. I would like to share my screen before I proceed further. So as Aditi told you all about me, I'm Dr. Kanika Wadhwa, and I'm a dentist and a cosmetologist, and I'm practicing in Gurugram for over a decade now. And specifically in aesthetic medicine, I'm practicing since 2018. Earlier, I did my PG diploma and fellowship in aesthetic medicine from Greifswald University, Germany. And afterwards, I have also pursued my fellowship in advanced aesthetic medicine from SDT College. It is in Haryana, Gurugram, Haryana. So the topic today is Botox in facial aesthetics. Before we move on to Botox, let's talk about effects of aging. As we see the youthful face on the left side, it presents the typical triangle of youth, in which our face is more convex and it has more volume in the mid-face. And when I talk about mid-face, the cheeks are more, they are fuller, and the chin is pointed. The face is more oval-shaped, and the cheekbone is more defined. Whereas with the effect of aging, it is a pyramid of aging, which typically present itself with drooping eyebrows, wrinkles on forehead, sagging cheeks, and hollowing of eyes, sagging jaws, and deepening of nasolabial fold, widening of nasal aperture, and downward turning of the mouth angle. So that's how you can see there is so a drastic change when the effects of aging are seen on the face, how the look changes. In youthful face, there are fat pads, and with the aging, these fat pads are lost, and there is sunken eyes, and likewise, the effect is seen all over the face. You can appreciate these are the facial fat pads which are present in the young age. Gradually with age, these are lost. And also the loss of fat pads and loss of volume on the face, it is covered more by the fillers. When we talk about Botox, it usually makes the wrinkles disappear. Why do the wrinkles appear? Because of the overactivity of the muscles, wrinkles appears perpendicular to the muscle activity. In whichever direction the muscle is hyperactive, just right perpendicular to it, there are fine lines which start appearing with age. These are dynamic or static. With aging, these lines can be seen, these wrinkles can be seen on the static face also. So we try and make them disappear with the help of Botox. So yeah, botulinum toxin is a superpower. We say it is a superpower because it makes the wrinkles disappear. So what exactly is botulinum toxin? It is derived from you must have heard about Clostridium botulinum. It is an anaerobic gram-positive bacteria, and it is extremely large neurotoxin molecule. It is around 900 kDa. It is more like a biochemistry part of this about this toxin. You must be knowing about it before we proceed and we work on it. This is the same bacteria which cause food poisoning or botulism. You must have heard about it. It has two types, type A and type B. Type A is most widely used in aesthetic medicine. Only in the cases where there is any clinical resistance to type A or there is any allergy to type A, then only type B is used. So these are the few trade names you can see: Botox, Dysport, Xeomin. These are all, they are used very commonly. So these are the uses of Botox. As I mentioned before also, apart from the uses in aesthetic medicine, it is widely used for the treatment of migraine and also for hyperhidrosis. It beautifully treats the patient of hyperhidrosis when we give Botox shots in armpits, on the palm, or on the soles. So it is widely used these days for these indications also. For aesthetic medicine, it is used for forehead lines, for crow's feet, and it instantly, when we use it on the patients with on forehead or with the crow's feet, you can instantly see the mood upliftment, because the person who's always seen frowning, or when Botox is done for that patient, you can instantly see the happy face and the mood transformation, because it makes you feel more happier and more cheerful. And glabellar lines are also removed with the help of Botox. Eyebrow lift. Eyebrow lift are very, very popular in females. They love it. And gummy smile. Gummy smile is again a very important indication, and especially for the dentist pursuing this botulinum toxin, they get patient of gummy smile very often in their clinic. Then lip lines, marionette lines, and bunny lines, under eye lines, and platysmal bands are also beautifully treated with the help of Botox. Apart from that, meso Botox is also used, or you can say Botox facial, which is helpful in removing the fine lines and giving instant glow to the patient. Now, coming on to the contraindications. Contraindications are myasthenia gravis, allergy to botulinum toxin, any neuromuscular disorder, of course, pregnancy and lactation, and allergy to albumin, because albumin is present in the ampule, which is containing the botulinum toxin. We'll come on to the mechanism of action. How does it work? Botulinum, bacteria, this molecule is extremely large, and it is a neurotoxic molecule, and it is extremely large. It is around 900 kDa. The main action is of the central segment, which is of 150 kDa. That is a central segment, neurotoxic core, we call it. It has heavy and light component. Heavy component is of 100 kDa. It acts on the axonic presynaptic ending. And the lighter part is the actual part, which light part, which is of 50 kDa, which reaches the actual nerve ending, and it leads to the cleavage of group of proteins we call snare proteins, which are responsible for not releasing acetylcholine, and it impairs the muscle muscle contraction and cause the paralysis and makes the muscle inactive. Which are these proteins? These are synaptobrevin and SNAP25 and syntaxin. These are the three proteins which the cleaving of these group of proteins, it stops that. And because of that, acetylcholine is not released, and it impairs the muscle contraction and it causes the muscle paralysis. Now, the surrounding portion, it is not of any pharmacological importance. It is there as a protective shield. It has accessory proteins, hemagglutinin and non-hemagglutinin. So now this Botox, it has, when this mechanism of action, it reaches it, we often say it reaches a peak at 7 to 14 days. Why doesn't act immediately? Why it takes around 7 to 14 days? Because as we discussed, it inhibits the production of acetylcholine further by inhibiting the cleavage of the snare proteins. Now the acetylcholine, which is already present on the synaptic nerve ending, it takes around 7 to 10 days or maximum 14 days to deplete completely and to show its inactivity. So that is the reason we say that Botox effect reaches its peak at 10 to 14 days. It starts from 7th day and then it reaches the peak from 10 to 14 days. So Botox action, as we discussed, it is a peripheral neuromuscular blocking agent. That is the reason when we discuss contraindications right now, we have seen that myasthenia gravis or neuromuscular disorders, we generally don't prefer using Botox because it is a neuromuscular blocking agent. So we don't want to use it in the conditions in which already the neuromuscular activity is being compromised. Botox, the ampule which we get, the 100 Botox unit vial, it has 0.5 milligram of human serum albumin as well. So whenever we have to see the contraindications, we have to see allergy to albumin also. So we have, while taking the history, we should always take, like the patients who are pure vegetarians who never had eggs and all, we should particularly check them for albumin sensitivity. And we have to store it in freezer until we reconstitute it. And after reconstitution also, we should refrigerate it. Uses we already discussed. Coming on to the contraindications once again, as I told you, I'll read out once again, myasthenia gravis, allergy to botulinum toxin, neuromuscular disorders, pregnancy and lactation, and allergy to albumin. Now, pre-Botox instructions. What are the instructions which we should be giving before giving injectables and particularly Botox? We should be avoiding aspirin or any non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs 7 to 10 days prior to the treatment. As you know, these are blood thinners, and while using injectables, for very obvious reason, we should avoid its use at least 7-10 days prior to it. We should avoid alcoholic beverages. We should stay well hydrated. Alcoholic beverages, because it further causes dehydration. And for any cosmetological procedure, more well hydrated the patient is, more beautiful are the results. Should avoid waxing, bleaching, and use of hair removal cream in the areas to be treated, because it makes them more sensitive. We don't want that. We should avoid sun exposure. Any history of active infections, skin infections, we should avoid it, like herpes simplex, cold sores, that should be avoided. And patient should share medical history, all the medicines the person is taking, and any allergies from food and drugs. Allergy part, I have already told what needs to be discussed particularly. Coming on to the procedure, before I discuss about the procedure, we should know about the reconstitution part, how to reconstitute it. So for reconstitution, we should be using 2.5 ml of saline. Use a fresh saline bottle, take 2.5 ml of saline, fill it in a syringe and introduce it to vial. It is a vacuumed vial, so it takes up the saline very quickly, and it makes 100 units of Botox. You can fill them in the insulin syringes, right? And now here, there are a few things to be taken care of. Saline should be introduced very gently to the vial to avoid foaming, because bubble resulting can cause the surface denaturation of protein. High concentration should be used for the accurate placement, and when we use for 50 unit, it should be 1.25 ml, and for 100 unit, it should be 2.5 ml. Efficacy variability is only when there are different formulation or when the pre-diffusion profile is different. Only then the efficacy variability is there. Now see, we have to clean the area to be treated with alcohol swab. We have to analyze our anatomical landmarks and active muscles to be targeted. Just like we give nerve blocks, we always and always analyze the landmarks first. We always analyze all anatomical landmarks well, and then only we proceed further. Likewise, we should clean the area to be treated with alcohol swab. We should analyze our anatomical landmarks and active muscles to be targeted, which we are trying to target. And just may say we want wrinkles to be disappeared. We should mark the injection site with white marker. And in case of any facial asymmetry, photographically, we should document it. This is a very, very important point. Sometimes patient is himself or herself not aware of the facial asymmetry. And later on, after you complete your case, what happens is patient complains like sometimes ki right side is like that, left side is like that. It was not like that before. So in case you observe any sort of facial asymmetry, right then at that time, you take photographs and document it photographically and inform your patient beforehand. You should always take the pre-procedure pics, and we should never overdo any of our cosmetological procedure. We can always underdo and do it later on. We can leave some scope of touch-up later on, but if we end up overdoing it, there is no way it can be undone. So overconfidence shouldn't be, in aesthetics, it doesn't work. So we shouldn't overdo any of the cosmetological procedure. So these are a few of the cases done by me. So in this patient, I've done crow's feet, frown lines, and micro buttocks. You can see the effect. In Botox, whenever you do like any case, say crow's feet or frown lines or whatever, micro Botox is a very, very beautiful procedure. Whatever toxin you're left with, you can dilute it. Already reconstituted toxin, you can dilute it further 3 times with saline. And you can use it as a meso Botox in all over the face. And then it leads to the instant glow, and that fine lines, they disappear. This is an immediate glow very next day. This is another case of fine lines in under eye area. This is one patient I treated for this temporal migraine. Initially, I started with temporal migraine. Now it has around 30 sites on the head for migraine. Now we are doing them all and it's giving very beautiful result. And this also, you can see how beautifully the lines and wrinkles have disappeared in this patient as well. So that's how we proceed. First of all, we'll apply Prilox. Prilox is any Prilox or top lap you can apply. You can leave it for, ideally it should be left for around 45 minutes to 1 hour. Then you can mark areas with white marker. Then you can use insulin syringes. Aapne jo reconstitute kiya hai Botox, you can fill them in insulin syringes. And depending on the area, we have to give our units. Now the post-treatment care. As I told you, results will be at the peak on the 14th day of the injection. It will be noticed. You'll start noticing it in 4 to 5 days. We don't have to touch or rub the injected site for 24 hours. We have to avoid exercise. We have to ask patient not to lie down and not to lean forward 4 to 6 hours after the treatment to prevent diffusion. We don't want Botox to diffuse. So we don't want patient to lie down or to lean forward. It can, and if there can be any slight chances of bruising, which can be presented in the form of tiny bumps or redness. It goes in couple of hours to couple of days, and ice packs are advised. We have to avoid, ask patient to avoid any facial or microderma abrasion, and massage for a few days. No gymming, sweating, or sauna, steam. Basically, no exposure to heat for 72 hours. Sometimes the water, which is tap water, it is full of pollutants, dust, and sometimes it is hard water. So we often ask patient to use distilled water or drinking water to wash face. We have to protect treated area from dust and pollutants. We have to avoid blood thinners for 3 days with the consent from the physician. Avoid smoking and alcohol for 24 to 48 hours. Avoid vitamin K and green tea. Vitamin K and green tea, just because same effect to blood thinning and all. That's the only reason. Do not sleep on your back for next 24 hours. Report immediately in case of rash, itching, or difficulty in breathing or blurring of vision. So a few things I would like to add here. First of all, Botox act on the principle of, like, when we make one muscle bit inactive, other muscles are in pair. If one muscle is elevating, one muscle would be depressor. One is elevator, one is depressor. So when we make one muscle a bit inactive, other muscles will become more active. So that's how the principle of Botox is. When we make one muscle a bit more inactive, the other muscle will have more action. So that's the beauty of it. So that's how it works, right? So it acts on the principle of balancing. Balancing ki principle pe it works. As I told you, whatever the facial muscle, whatever the muscles are, jo bhi unka action hota hai, if action is like this, the wrinkles are perpendicular to it. So in order to make the wrinkles disappear, we have to target those muscles. And the depth of injections are different for different areas. Now, as I told you, as we discussed already, that why is there delay in the action? Because it is the time required for the depletion of acetylcholine, which is already present. Now, another thing is that why the effect is temporary. Now, once we have given it, now why the effect is temporary? Because the new axonal, the new sprout formation, it takes around 3 to 6 months. The neurogenesis pathway re-establish ho jata hai within 3 to 6 months. So you will see that within 3 to 4 months, maximum 5 months, there is re-establishment and there is neurogenesis again, and the effect is no more. Of Botox effect cannot be seen anymore. So that's the reason. And here what we missed was the role of consent form is very, very important when it comes to any of the when we talk about any cosmetological procedure, the role of consent form cannot be overlooked. We have to take consent form before we proceed for any of the treatment. So that is very important. I think apart from that, we have covered it all. We'll take up the queries and later on in the comment section, whatever the queries you have, as Aditi has mentioned, you can leave it in the comment box, the question answer part. About botulinum toxin, the conclusion is that it is a very, very powerful neurotoxin, and it causes the atrophy of muscle. It changes the muscle pattern, size, and dynamic action. And it has the mood, as I told you, it has a mood improving effect, because when naturally the glabellar complex is treated, when frown lines are treated, you can see the person mood is instantly, it can be seen that it is instantly lifted up. And as I told you, apart from the widespread use in aesthetic medicine, it is used for therapeutic reasons as well, like in the treatment of migraine and hyperhidrosis. So I think we have covered it all, the insight and the introduction part of botulinum in the facial aesthetic medicine. Now we will handing over to you, Aditi, again, and would like to answer all the questions from here only. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this amazing presentation. And I'm sure everyone is so encouraged to, you know, start practicing Botox administration in their practices now. So before moving on to the question and answer session, I'll be introducing all the participants to our organization. Just give me 1 minute. Yes. So this is our organization, Dentist Channel Online, with the motto, Healthy Smiles That Leads to Wealthy Lives. I request all everyone to kindly make a note of this website, www.dentistchannel.online. Here you can log in and you can find everything and anything you want to know about dentistry and our organization. Basically, our company is a digital dental marketing company which is striving very hard to bring all the dental professionals and dental marketing companies under one roof and creating opportunities for each and every one. So, and we conduct a lot of webinars and workshops every week and month. And being a Prime member, you can get a lot of opportunities. Like you'll be receiving e-certificate for each and every event that you attend. And the annual membership, the annual Prime membership will cost you just 499 rupees. So I request you, this is one sample certificate which you'll receive after the completion of the webinar. You can log into our website, www.dentistchannel.online, and you can, plus I have provided the link for annual Prime membership on the chat box. So you can go on to that and subscribe to our Prime membership. Now, I request everyone to kindly take a screenshot and save this number and send your name as a message on this number, and you will be added to our broadcast list and you will be updated regarding each and every upcoming events that we have. These are our sponsors, www.novamind.gmbh. You can log in there, and it is the dental implant company, innovative dental and healthcare solutions to ensure your success. For recorded videos, you can follow us on Facebook and YouTube and Instagram with the handle Dentist Channel Online. Okay. So now let's quickly move on to the question and answer session. Okay, Ms. Dr. Bhupinder, I request you to kindly drop your questions in the question and answer box. But let's start with this only. How to inject? What is the technique to inject botulinum toxin?
See, because the different areas will have different technique, and we have to, depth of injection is different for different areas. So this was an introductory session to get a basic insight about the Botox. As I told you, after reconstitution, we have to load them in insulin syringes. We have to make a pinch grasp, and we have to basically analyze the anatomical position, which anatomical landmark where we are injecting. And then accordingly, sir, we have to, area by area we can discuss, because every area will have a different technique. So that we can cover in the upcoming sessions, and before also the session, in sessions it has been covered. Like we can take the forehead part in one session and eye part in another, then the lower face in another session. And then we can discuss in detail how many units and where to inject, how to inject, that all can be covered.
Moving on to the next question. How to check Botox allergy?
For Botox allergy, as I mentioned, in that vial, there is botulinum toxin as well as albumin. So for allergy to albumin, you can first of all ask the patient if the patient is, the patients who are pure vegetarian who never had eggs, we have to check for two allergies, first to albumin also and then to botulinum also. So what I generally do is that, in that case, you can dilute it further 3 to 4 times, and you can give it on the neck or somewhere, you know, at the back of the ear, very little amount, with just 1 or 2 units, and dilute it further 3 to 4 times. Basically, it will be a mesobotox kind. What the dilution which we give in mesobotox, that same dilution we can follow. We can give 1 or 2 units at the back of the ear or somewhere. Just 1 or 2 units, and we can watch for 24 hours for any allergies or any redness, any problems, and then only we can proceed for the main Botox after mesobotox.
So moving on to the next question by Dr. Buttle. is asking how to do micro Botox. Do you just spray it on face or do you use derma roller?
So derma roller is obsolete these days because instead of derma roller, for PRP, PRF, we are preferring more derma pen these days. There are videos also, I will share it later to Aditi or in the comment section, which shows the effect of derma roller versus derma pen. So that is altogether a different thing. But for Botox, I'm not using derma pen, not even derma roller. What you have to do is reconstituted Botox, just take it, dilute it further 3 times more. Like you are left, whenever I do any patient of Botox, I always convince them for micro Botox as well. Whatever units you are left with, say you are left with 8 units of Botox, you dilute it further to 3 times more. So you will be having 24, 25 units in hand. So what you can do, you can make grid all over the face like this. You can make grid here, everywhere, forehead, cheeks, everywhere. You can cover under eye area also because it is absolutely safe. Micro Botox is relatively safer and we can use it in the sensitive areas like under eye area, neck bands. Platysmal bands are beautifully covered by micro Botox. So you can make a grid over under eye area also, all over face, neck also. And there you have to just raise the bleb with insulin syringe and just come out. Raise the bleb and come out. Raise the bleb and come out. Just inject little all over. And when you raise the blebs all over, it gives a beautiful result. Just like the way you do PRP face, it is the same way, exactly same way. Only the places where we have to avoid is the open, any open wound, any pimple, any open cut or wound, there you can avoid. Apart from that, you can cover in the entire face and neck region. And specifically for neck and under eye area, it is a very beautiful procedure.
So moving on to the next question, Dr. Vinod is asking a note on temporalis migraine diagnosis.
Sorry, what do you want to ask?
He's asking temporalis migraine diagnosis. I'm sure this is not related to our topic today.
No, because he has asked this migraine because I covered one of my case, that is temporal migraine, which we covered. Mm-hmm. The migraine diagnosis, you don't have to make. That will come, like patient who will be already diagnosed with migraine and who will come to you with already diagnosed migraine, only you have to treat them. Otherwise, the diagnosis is it is a unilateral pain and only the ye jo aapka temporalis muscle hota hai, fan shape, here C shape, yahan pe particularly point pe throbbing pain hota hai patient ko. And this pain is referred to eye area also, pre-auricular and post-auricular area also, and it radiates further to the center of the head. So both throbbing sa unilateral sa pain hota hai, and patient jo bhi patient botox ke treatment ke liye aayenge wo sure diagnosis se hi aate hai. They are referred to us by a neurologist. These days neurologists also refer their patients to the facial aesthetic medicine expert for botox shots, because patients are suffering so much that they are very they are relying on botox a lot for migraine treatment.
Dr. Fazil is asking, could you please share the consent form? Okay, we can do that later on once we are done with the webinar. And can you suggest some book for Botox and facial aesthetic procedures?
Yeah, books also. I will share link to Aditi and she can share. Sure. I will share.
And now moving on to the next question. Will you be able to show injection sites for the same? Especially for lower two-third of the face and trigeminal neuralgia, if it's possible.
Yeah, that can be done. But as I told you now, that injection techniques would be altogether a new topic. Like it will be a 1 hour topic if we talk about lower face or about forehead or about crow's feet. That has to be taken up as a separate topic. Mm-hmm. So yes, we can plan with Aditi for upcoming sessions and we can cover.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You are talking now, it is about bruxism and clenching. So fir hame wo vaccinator ka pura marking and that we have to discuss. So we will surely do that in upcoming.
Okay. Last question, how to check patient is allergic to albumin?
Albumin ke liye to dear, you will have to ask if patient is already like, agar wo apni allergy bata hi rahe hain ki X se allergy hai. Patient who tells you that, jab aap food or drug allergy ki, when you take history and patient is telling you that he or she is allergic to X, then you cannot go for Botox at all. I would not recommend you to go for botulinum toxin at all, because we have discussed in vial there is albumin. If patient is pure vegetarian like me, mm-hmm. then you cannot ask the patient to have albumin first and come to you and then you will do his or her procedure. For that, you will have to take a chance. As I told you, you will have to dilute Botox further to 3 or 4 times and then inject a very little quantity at the back of ear or neck or somewhere which is not visible. Wahan pe thoda sa, just give 1 or 2 units. 24 to 48 hours, you will get to know patient is allergic or not, and then you can proceed. If patient is pure vegetarian, you cannot do anything about it.
Right. So we are done with our questions. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this amazing session. And I'm quite sure that very soon we'll be planning a new session with you.
Sure. And we can discuss in detail about the injection techniques. In that, we will divide it into 2-3 subtopics, like in upper face, lower face. We can take up the migraine or hyperhidrosis also, but that will be altogether a different session. And yes, I also invite thoroughly to have such an interactive audience when participants put up their questions, they ask their queries. So we as speaker also enjoy a bit more, and we also like to share our knowledge.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am. So with this, we are ending our session. Thank you to all the participants for being with us. And so with this, we are ending our session. Thank you, and good night to everyone.
Good night, dear. Thank you so much.